Thanks once again for dropping by the channel. If you like the content, if you're new to the channel, please hit subscribe, share the video if you enjoyed it, if you felt it was useful. Now let's get into this. So Dave Benavidez stops Alexis Angulo in the 10th round. I believe the corner stopped after 10 rounds. I mean, wow. Angulo took a beating in there. He really did. He came on strong for the first two rounds. You know, he was, you know, getting Dave Benavidez up against the ropes, trying to land a few shots. But from then on in, I mean, damn, he just took a beating. You know, he's got a chin on him. That's one thing I will say. He has a hell of a chin on him because he took loads of shots to the head. Especially that 10th round before he got stopped was bad. You know, that was a really, really bad beating he took in that round in particular. Like, the referee was on the verge of stopping, I think, but the kind of worst of the storm came with about 15 seconds to go in the round. 15, 20 seconds to go in the round. Where Benavidez was just landing at will. He was literally just landing at will. He was landing hooks to the head, uppercuts as well to the head. He was landing some good shots to the body. And Benavidez had a field day in there. Benavidez missed weight, obviously, as we know, by basically 3 pounds. So he's 171 pounds. So the title is now vacant because he obviously won this fight. So the title now becomes vacant. Benavidez looked soft in there. And when I say soft, I don't mean in terms of his boxing ability or anything like that, or his, you know, killer instinct. I mean, his body looked a little bit soft. When I was watching this fight, you could noticeably see, like, Benavidez never been the most chiseled 168 pounder. I think that's fair to say. But when I looked at him in the ring, and I could see some of the fat, literally some of the fat just kind of moving whenever he was throwing shots, it did have me think, you know, how disciplined were you going into this camp? You know, could you, if you really wanted to, could you have made that 168 pounds if you'd been a little bit more disciplined, if you'd done a little bit of things differently? I suspect you probably could have. So, in terms of Benavidez moving forward after this fight, you know, he was naming Caleb Plant after the fight, and obviously that fight was being discussed originally, before all this lockdown went ahead, and, you know, that would have been a unification, that would have been IBF, WBC unifying. If the fight happens now, it would just be Caleb Plant defending his IBF title, and when you look at Dave Benavidez, you think to yourself, you know, Caleb Plant, really, since he's fought with Cat's guy, he's not really fought anybody. You look at Benavidez in the 168-pound division, and you think to yourself, right, if he's staying there and he's got no title, who realistically is going to give him a voluntary title shot? No one. He's a big problem for any 168-pounder. He's a very, very big man. He made some mistakes in there, just technical mistakes. I mean, obviously, he felt as though he didn't have much coming back at him by way of the opponent. Angulo, although he was game for the first couple of rounds and he was trying his best the first couple of rounds, I think Benavidez felt that maybe he's not the biggest puncher in the world. Maybe he's got nothing really to bother him with, because there was times he was opening up and throwing some combinations. And literally, he was finishing those combinations with chin, literally just standing as upright as you can, chin wide in the air, hands down by the waist. And, you know, he did get caught a couple of times with hooks by Angulo when, you know, he was basically just throwing a shot, standing upright, having little no regard for defense, because I'm assuming he obviously just didn't feel there was much coming back at him, you know. So when he was obviously up against the ropes, you know, he was obviously, you know, doing a good job, you know, blocking the shots, all that. But when he was on offense, he really didn't seem to have, you know, a care in the world for what was coming back at him. Some people were impressed with Angulo because he beat Anthony Sims Jr. But Anthony Sims Jr., at the time, he still is. He's an untested prospect. Now, he looked good beating a few guys who, you know, didn't come to fight or didn't really come to give much resistance. But when he stepped up, obviously he lost. Benavidez is a different beast altogether. Now, he's a problem for any super middleweight if he stays in that division. If he moves up to light heavyweight, that's a tough division. It is. You got guys like Dmitry Bivol. You got guys like Beterbiev. Beterbiev is dangerous. You know, that man is a dangerous, dangerous man. And he is, what, WBC and IBF champion. He's dangerous. And obviously, you've got Dmitry Bivol. Dmitry Bivol is kind of in a round light heavy super middleweight. That might be a decent fight, actually. But with regards to Benavidez, I think, judging by what he was saying in the post fight, I think he maybe will try and stay at super middleweight. But I think that the lack of discipline, I mean, like, he's lost his title twice. He's a two-time WBC champion, super middleweight. He's never lost his title in the ring. He's always lost it outside the ring. You know, he was popped for taking, you know, an illegal recreational substance, we'll call it. Just won't call it by his real name. When was that? About 2, 3 years, 2 years ago, 3 years ago, maybe, I'm not sure. But it was a couple of years ago anyway. He was popped for that, which kind of leads me to believe that, you know, this is a guy who likes the nightlife, he likes the party. And now he's come in overweight. In the ring, he's looked like, you know, I'll say he looked like he's carrying a bit extra weight. He didn't have like a pot belly or anything like that, but he definitely looked soft. You know, we're used to seeing heavyweights, the odd cruiserweight, look a bit soft, but when we're coming at like super middle, light, heavy, it's very rare you see them have, you know, a bit of softness to them. But Benavidez did look that way. So I do wonder if he decides to stay at super middleweight, will he be a little bit more disciplined? All right, because there's that, and I know some people, you could say, well, you know, maybe for Benavidez to lose those extra few pounds or to lose that bit of, you know, stubborn fat, it's a bit trickier. Yeah, I get that, but I'm sure there's a way. You know, I'm sure that if you are that little bit more disciplined, if you can just avoid doing one or two things differently, I'm sure you can get rid of it. So those are my thoughts on this. Like I said, it was a decent performance. Like, he really was hitting the heavy bag. Yeah, I mean, towards the end of the 10th round, I was just like, they have to stop this fight. I mean, I didn't watch it live. I watched it the next day. But still, while I'm watching that, I'm just like, yeah, they need to stop this fight because the guy didn't win a round. He was taking a beating in there. Benavidez, one thing I'll say, Angulo has one hell of a chin on him. Because Benavidez is not feather fisted. He can punch. And this guy took his best shots and just kept on coming. Literally. So that was one of those occasions where he needed to be safe from himself because he wasn't going to quit. Benavidez, if he kept going, he could have done some serious damage. So, and those are my thoughts on this. Like I said, clockwork performance from Benavidez. Just annoying that, you know, he's lost his title again, and it's not come as a result of him losing in the ring. It's come as a result of him, you know, doing things outside the ring that will hinder him. And these things will hinder him in the long run. That's inevitable. These things are going to hinder him in the long run. So I'd like to see a bit more discipline from Benavidez. Like I said, he is still quite young, but you know, the discipline, I'd like to see that change. You know, if he's planning on sticking around super middleweight, he really should try his hardest just to make sure he's on point, on weight, and you know, in the best shape he can be. So those are my thoughts on this. Let me know yours down below. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, please leave a like, subscribe, of course, if you are new, and as always, people, I will talk to you.